why would we as Africans continue to rely on exportation of our saints when we have what it takes to actually produce, distribute, and market these vaccines?
Africa is gifted with the most diverse genetic material on the planet.
We have to be out there talking to the private sector, talking to the foundations, talking to the sovereign wealth funds.
Wherever you wake up is your money. We have just woken up, and we must continue to pursue this agenda with CODA and all stakeholders to ensure that we can provide vaccines for Africa.
What CODA and Igbinedion University Okada are saying is that non-state actors' views and actions are equally important.
Africa has experienced several diseases, outbreaks, and epidemics in the past.
We have candidates and targets for both medicines and vaccines. So manufacture should have been a logical step in terms of our response and our capabilities.
What we've done today in Nigeria is proof of concept, but the agenda is Pan-African. The agenda is Africa. Keep your eyes on the prize.
CODA stands for the Coalition for Dialogue on Africa. It is a platform for dialogue and debate, frank, open, inclusive, at times very controversial dialogues and debate, and on very rare occasions, we step in to see through the pursuit of policies.
Since private sector is ready and they believe this is a viable opportunity, we need social connection with the government to provide us the enabling environment.
Africa must own and control its public health response to make it applicable to its populations.
Africans can work together and produce a vaccine. We have to depend on African money. He or she who pays the piper calls the tune.
Not Gabon doing its own thing, Nigeria doing its own thing, and then another country from the north says, oh no, that's a West African initiative. We will not be part of it.
We want Africa not free from hunger, but well nourished. Not free from disease, but healthy. Not free from poverty, but wealthy. Not free from illiteracy, but well educated.
CODA, an instrument of the African Union, has decided to bring everybody together to say, let's put an end to this.
Just 2 months ago, we held a dialogue involving the academics, researchers, scientists, public health experts, youth, civil society, faith leaders, and community leaders to discuss how to increase access to vaccine and vaccination in Africa.
And also to be able to give that confidence that the professor is talking about to the private sector, to see in this an opportunity.
That is the key. We must be confident that we can do it and not thinking that we will be laughed at by so advanced economies.
During that dialogue, I had pledged my commitment to ensuring that recommendations from the dialogue are implemented and with speed. I am glad to let you know that today's launch is in fulfillment of that promise, and it marks the beginning of new partnership and collaborations that will see our continent play a lead role in vaccine development, production, and distribution.
If you want Africans to work together as a bloc, you must be able to say, I'm an African first, a citizen of ECOWAS second, a Nigerian third. I know you don't want to hear that, but that's what you must psychologically prepare yourself as an African if you are going to work together to unlock the economies of scale that are required for us to manufacture vaccines on the continent.
I think together what CODA is doing is to build trust, is to build exactly this partnership and leadership, and totally you have the full support of the private health sector here.
But procuring and administering the vaccine are, however, costly exercises that put African countries at disadvantage.
It's time If we really want together the 54 countries under African Union, all of us as partners, it's time that all of Africa, the Africa 2063 Development Agenda is about a prosperous, peaceful, integrated Africa driven by the citizens of Africa.
Despite having 14% of the world's population and being the region that is disproportionately affected by infectious diseases, Africa accounts for less than 0.1% of the world's vaccine production capacity.
Vaccines have helped the world to deal with the various debilitating ailments and potentially devastating infections and diseases that could have spiraled into pandemics and spelled global doom.
Public health research is indeed capital intensive, but we must also realize that health business is everyone's business. Judging from our experience with the COVID-19 pandemic,
that is why we need to bring together stakeholders, including African public and private universities, research institutions, as well as the African private sector, in facilitating access to vaccines and vaccination in Africa.
Therefore, the launch of an independent task team on the equitable and universal access to vaccines and vaccination in Africa, the initiative of the Coalition for Dialogue on Africa, CODA, and its partners, is therefore occurring at the right time in the history of vaccines and vaccinations.
I'd like to assure you of the commitment and support of the African Union Commission towards the success of this laudable homegrown initiative targeted at improving healthcare in Africa by improving access to vaccines and vaccination.